Hi everyone, my name is Jake and today I'd like to share tool tips and tricks on coloring your comics. This video will cover tips and advice on coloring shortcuts, lighting, gradient maps, and layer effects, all of which can be accomplished in Clip Studio Paint. For other videos and tutorials on the topic, check out the links in the description. One key difference between coloring in illustration and coloring for your comic is that you are focusing primarily on speed. Depending on how often you are releasing your comics, the size of your team, your publishing method, and the time you can dedicate to your comic between other life responsibilities, you'll want to find shortcuts that won't cut into the quality of your work, but will still save you time. The first step I use is color blocking. I select a single color and use it to block out areas to keep colors in when I color over top it, usually separated by character, foreground, and background. To do this quickly, my method is to use the Close and Fill tool, located under Fill on the toolbar. Select your line art layer and set as reference layer, then create a new layer beneath it. With the Close and Fill tool selected, check the tool property window that you have the lighthouse selected next to the Refer Multiple option. With your chosen color and new layer selected, use the tool to select around the layer you want to fill in, and the program will do the rest. Make sure the lines are unbroken or it won't register the fill. You can do the same thing with a regular fill tool, which you can even click and drag across your drawing. To reduce gaps in your color, consider playing with the color margin and close gap settings of your fill tool. The color margin setting, or error margin, specifies how similar a color or transparency has to be to register the fill. The close gap setting, when enabled, fills by closing gaps up to a certain number of pixels. If you still notice little parts are still missing color, sweep over everything with the Paint Unfilled Area tool. Color blocking is a good way to make it easier and faster to put your final colors down. The easiest way for me to do this was to create a folder above the color block layer, but below the line art, and then toggle Clip to Layer Below. The folder will then read the blocked colors below it as a guide to keep the next colors in. Then, whatever new layers you add to the folder will all register the same way. Next, let's talk a bit about lighting. For comics, lighting can be broken down into two main factors, direction of light and mood. Because you're creating comics, you want to maintain consistency through the panels, so keeping track of where your characters are relative to the light source and the reader's view is going to be important. When you're ready to apply your light source, consider the type of shading and lighting style you want to use. Some artists shade and highlight with black and white, some use different colors, and some don't shade at all. There are also the amounts of detail in shading, which can range from cell shading to soft. There are pros and cons to every method, but my favorite is cell shading. It's the easiest to adapt and is ideal for speed, and it also fits with my style. Additionally, when you shade, unless you've already established some skill in black and white, consider using desaturated colors and it will greatly improve the quality of your work. Also, an advantage to coloring your comics is the level of mood lighting you can make that can't be achieved in black and white comics. One way you can do this is to use gradient maps. Gradient maps take the existing values of the layer colors and give them colors with a predefined spectrum. You can do this by going to Edit, Tonal Correction, Gradient Map. Clip Studio comes with some lighting defaults, and you can even find more gradient maps in the Asset Store that can give you all kinds of fun colors to experiment with. Once you've picked a gradient you like, click OK, and it'll apply the gradient to the layer. If you want to have the gradient applied in a separate layer, just duplicate the color layer you want to apply the gradient to. You can manipulate the lighting and gradient maps easier with layer effects. Layer effects are nifty blending tools that can be applied to your layers to make things pop or blend together, and it can make your life really easy if you know how to apply them. Layer effects can be found under the Blending Mode drop-down menu just above your layer list. The sheer amount of options can be daunting, but there are usually only a few you ever really use. For shading, I favor the Multiply option. This takes the color value and saturation of the layer and applies it to the one below it, making it darker and blending the shade color I used and the base color below it to create the effect I want. This can also be done with highlights, for which I alternate between Add, Glow, and Overlay, and adjust the transparency of the layer to get the results I want. These aren't the only ones I'll use either, as there are so many blending options and they all can have really very neat effects. Consider playing around and finding out what works best for you. What's really wonderful about Clip Studio is that all these tools are available by default, and there's a large library of tools made by users for users, all available in the Clip Studio Asset Store. Although I believe ultimately the tools don't make the artist, Clip Studio makes the comic creating process incredibly streamlined and user-friendly for beginners and masters alike. I hope you found this video helpful, and I wish you luck on your comic journey. Thank you for watching, and until next time.